I believe Parliament succeeds each other, and specifically the current Speaker, or the father of the House of the last Parliament, and the minority leaders and the majority leaders have not changed and were obviously intrinsic to the decision. My petition was not specifically to the First Lady, but I didn't understand in what circumstances Parliament had passed these recommendations, which on the face of it look probably unconstitutional. We've always had a situation in this country where the offices of First and Second Ladies have been supported at great cost to the state. You know, they have provided actual buildings, vehicles, staff, etc., all of which have been charged to the president's budget. And there's been no real worry about it. But suggesting that they should then be paid personally, I think that was offensive in many ways, apart from it being unconstitutional. But if I could say something, the INTM's committee actually said, regularize this by bringing legislation to cover it. I have not seen any legislation that has been put forward before any kind of payments were made. So for me, that was the worry, that the informality which had surrounded these things for years was being repeated even in taking action on the matter of the current payments. I did congratulate the First Lady for returning the money. I think whoever drafted the letter that accompanied it was a little bit insensitive to the discussions that were going on. But it's a great gesture that the money was returned. We should continue to support the offices of incumbent First and Second Ladies. All the rest, I don't think I subscribe to paying wives of military leaders, widows of military leaders, etc., and paying First and Second Ladies post their leave in office.
But thank you so much for watching. Subscribe and click on that bell icon and get notified every time we share something new. You know, we always share something new. Stay consistent.